Tampa making a comeback, winning game two to force this final winner take all versus MCES. Ladies and gentlemen, get out of your chairs to root on for your favorite. Here it goes. Who is going to win the first ever Clash of Clans World Championship?
The first attacker for Nova Esports in this tiebreaker round will be UZP, fresh off a 2-star 91%, followed up with a 3-star strike. This Queen Charge Hog Rider Master is looking to start things off strong for this Nova team.
He's looking to come in with the Queen Charge Hog Riders here, dropping the King up on the top side. Nova is attacking first here, meaning MCES will have the final attack if it comes down to that. I wonder if that's going to play a huge role in the war here to determine who's going to win it all, Woody.
He's so skilled with this one strategy and uses it nearly every time, and it works almost every time. UZP makes it look easy as pie. Here we go with the charge from the top. Only drops one healer, maybe checking for some air mines on the backside. Takes down those air skellies, and they will start to make their way toward that town hall. First star will be easy to grab for UZP. Pulls out a few more troops from that clan castle and will have lots of range to clear them out before moving in to the key defense.
Now the queen is going to be working on this clan castle, drops the poison on the lava hound and the archers. Hopefully the poison will be able to last through the pups that come out. Maybe let's look to see what he's going to drop. If he's going to help clear them, the queen might just take it the whole time. And then we have just under 2 minutes. There is the topside archer to help that queen there. Let's keep our eye on where this queen's gonna go. These healers look to be maybe in range of this town hall. I don't know if she's gonna get there. There's some wall breakers. Are they gonna open this wall in time? The town hall activates and the wall does actually open. He's gonna open the next compartment here too. This is looking pretty good. Woody, if he can charge here and keep this queen alive.
He'll be able to get the queen onto the enemy eagle artillery if he can keep her going over on the left side, but he spent so many spells to get her active. Now that enemy eagle artillery and the archer queen are gonna be within her sights, but he's gonna choose to deploy the hogs a bit earlier. Doesn't wanna run out of time. He's already spent half of his time on this attack in stage one. He needs these hogs to go at lightning speed to wreck the rest of this base. 50% 2-star is good, but 3 stars is what he's after.
Look at that queen under the rage. Gonna be able to take out the backside multi-target inferno. Grand Warden is following these hogs through. They're gonna be able to heal through this multi-target inferno here. Still has another heal and that freeze spell. Look at this. The queen is on the outside. This is looking really good for Nova to kick off game number 3 in the grand finals. Woody here.
Nova Esports. UZP pops his fist, confident that 3 stars are in his sights. They're going to be cashing in on their first strike, and UZP is going home happy. Whatever happens with the rest of this battle, remember that UZP started off right for Nova.
What a way to kick it off. They started off at a 3-star right there with the Queen Charge Hog Riders. What a pressure hit, and he comes through in the clutch.
Momentum swings back to MCES. Not happy with a 3-star hit to start things off, but they've got a few tricks still left up their sleeves. We'll take one quick look at the replay as we see an Archer Queen boosted to maximum capacity, tearing through the enemy Archer Queen and a multi-target Inferno on the backside. Super high value for UZP and an expertly designed attack.
Able to take that one down. That was against Senti's base 2, which is the closer of MCS. And now we have the leadoff attacker, Hugo Stiglitz, at a 93% average destruction, and he knows this is the last attack here in the Clash of Clans World Championship for him. If he's gonna be able to help MCS answer the call, it's the moment, and it has to be this attack right here, right now, Woody.
No fright from the Frenchman. Hugo Stiglitz attacks quick off the bat right on this corner side. He's gonna try to take down this town hall early on to give that Laloon assault on the back end a bit more clearance to not have to worry so much about that town hall with the first star already claimed. He's got 19 balloons, holding on to those 5 healers a bit longer to try to see if he can grab a Seeking Air Mine and keep them under protection, but looks like it's not gonna be necessary this time, Carbon.
Looks like the queen's gonna be walking towards the bottom side here. Maybe she might loop into the town hall. I'm not gonna see. Oh no, let's see if these walls Lawbreaker has to drop this rage to open up this compartment. The spray trap! Oh no! Does not open the compartment. Now the queen's gonna go over to the right, and she's gonna be able to help grab that town hall, but he wanted the queen to go left and maybe go for that multi-target inferno. He's gonna have to adapt on the fly, has to drop potentially some balloons for the multi once it locks onto these healers to keep the queen alive and going through the core here, Woody.
These healers are not happy about their queen passing off into the wrong direction here. Wallbreaker's not going to give her the in that she was looking for. Still, though, he's getting some decent value off of her quick strike onto the town hall. She'll try to make her way into the interior of this base, but with that multi-target inferno firing away at those healers, they're going to be in a tight spot.
Looks like he was able to freeze that multi and get the wall break in. Is the queen gonna loop in? Yes, the queen's coming back around. What a beautiful adjustment here on the fly, keeping these healers alive. And now it's not looking too bad with the queen going to the core, still has her royal cloak. He's gonna have to fly these balloons around because there's only about a minute and 10 seconds left in the raid here, Woody.
Hugo Stiglitz is huge and sticking it to UZP, sends in the Lava Hound to protect these balloons, haste them up on the backside, and that Grand Warden is looking ready to pop that ability at any moment. The big ol' Stone Slammer swoops in as well, giving additional coverage and massive damage for this attack. That enemy Archer Queen is dealing a ton of damage to this raid, though. Hold on, is that the attacking Archer Queen?
No, queen,
that's the enemy.
His queen just took out the enemy Archer Queen right here. Barely kind of traded blows right there. The queen goes down, but now he's going to fly through here with the Stone Slammer on the top side. These healers are coming around to actually cross tank for this Stone Slammer with 29 seconds left. Can he finish this one off? We still have the King platform. Drops a minion there. Perfectly timed to help take that down, but no more spells.
Look at the Hog Rider.
Look, he's going.
Championship as we start off.
Three stars, so unfortunate. Now it gives MCES a boost to come in with Linade hitting at a 98% destruction. Can he answer the call? What Hugo just did with the triple for MCES.
LP punctures that base and drops a punctuation mark, but it's the period, not an exclamation point. Linade is gonna be coming in once again for MCES. He's got the chance to pull ahead now, but even a really super high percentage two-star would not be enough to come over the top of Nova with that 97% we just saw from L period.
Yeah, the queen wants to charge here, and as it looks like a Sui Lao doesn't have any healers, maybe this queen can grab this town hall, pop the ability before the clan castle comes out. He wants to poison that to slow it down. Get ready for the queen ability. There it comes. Pops it. Hopefully these skelly stones stop this queen. The town hall should go down. It does. Perfectly right there. And hopefully the queen does not pop this hound. Shouldn't right there. Should stay alive. And it's looking pretty good here. He has to have something in the stone slammer to take care of the enemy queen because there's no skeleton in this composition.
This MCES Nova show match is gonna see one more repeat of the qualifier performance. We actually saw MCES and Nova face off in, I believe it was July, when MCES picked up a win off of Nova's 99% two-star. They got one more star last time, and it might happen one more time here. We're really enjoying the show, but of course, there's also a ton of mining on the line, and the title of World Champions, Linade, is going to be sending in a big old close support. This Electro Dragon balloon strike into the core of this base, Carmen.
Look at that E-Drag killing the enemy queen right there beautifully. Now he's flying around. He has some clone spells used actually on the balloons flying with this Grand Warden. This is looking really strong. Look at all these balloons popping the Grand Warden Eternal Tome. He's going to have to move through this back end multi. He freezes the air defense, the multi-target inferno. He has another freeze and haste in the back. Can he get through this? Ladies and gentlemen, Linade might be getting another three-star for MCES.
When life gives you lemons, you make Linade turn him into a three-star. The balloons are unstoppable. The biggest force and most leftover troops I think we clean up. MCES pulls ahead with 6 stars total.
Wow, now Nova's going to have to answer the call. MCES going back-to-back triples. Hugo starting it off for MCES, and now Linnade with the Electrone. Beautiful job with plenty of time left, over 30 seconds, and that is going to give another 3-star to MCES.
MCES back, and their eyes are locked onto the trophy and onto the World Championship title. But don't forget, on the Nova side,
those defense targeting troops like balloons to go after it.
Not only was MCS up on the stars, but now they dipped below on percentage, so it is completely swung into Nova's favor at this point. Oh my goodness, if you thought MCS was running away with this, that's not the call, because Nova is coming away, and can they answer with one attacking right here?
It might be the case. Let's see Juan as he goes in one last time. Picked up 2-star hits from his last 2 matches against MCES using Pekka Smash into Hogs and then the Law Loon hit. Now he's going with Mass E-Drags, totally switching it up against Hugo Stiglitz now. Let's see how he starts things off. It's going to be a queen charge from the top, but no healers to support her. Just going to try to get, I don't know, maybe do you think he was aiming for the multi in the top? I'm not sure what this queen is going
to
do.
He's just going to try to set the funnel for these E-Dragons. Juan is one of the best E-Dragon attackers in the game, and he's going to try to get it done, have this Stone Slammer move up and grab that multi-target in front of go from the Wizard. Wait a second, is it not going to go there? It's going to leave the multi up. Out comes the Dragon. E-Dragons are going to go, poisoning the enemy Dragon here. Keep your eye on where they're going. It's going to come down to the Chain Lightning and the value that he's going to get. Town Hall is activated. Pops the Grand War Eternal Tome, locks up the star right there. But now we have to keep our eye on, can he push through the rest of this base and help Nova get the even a greater advantage?
Air Sweeper in the interior is going to start trying to push back, but Juan says, no way, Jose. He's got the free spell to shut it down. Keep those E-Drags on target. Chaining Lightning throughout the entire interior. He's got 3 multi-target infernos. Check that. 2 multi-target infernos. Wait, check that. 1 multi-target inferno left to worry about as he finishes off the key defenses here. He's got still 1 air defense up on the top side, but 3 stars seems within his grasp, Carbon.
And MCS definitely was looking really nervous right now. Can Nova keep the consistency and get the next 3-star? They're looking, they're smiling there. Has a handful of E-Dragons. Where are these balloons going to be going to? There is the Tesla over at 3 o'clock. They might split in different directions or just go to this Archer Tower. But if there's enough balloons to get through this Archer Tower, make their way to this air defense, only 2 more E-Drags in here flying around. Does he have enough to get through this one, Woody?
He'll make it toward the air defense. A big old Seeking Air Mine comes out. The air defense goes down! The last drop from the balloon gets the job done, and those are 2 really healthy-looking E-Drags. I think they might have it in the bag.
Oh my goodness, this one's going to be really close. Can he get it with about 55 seconds left in the raid? The E-Drag doesn't have much health left. It needs to take on this multi-target Inferno. The Grand Warden, it's looking like a 3-star from Juan.
Excitement from the Nova team, jumping up and down, knocking the pillow off their chair. They've done it. Juan picks up the 3-star and gives Nova a dominant lead.
Unbelievable. Juan steps up in the clutch in game number 3 to give them the advantage. And MCS is not only down by that triple, they're down by overall percentage. So MCS has to 3-star or hope for something to go completely wrong. But we're looking at Juan's attack that helped get this 3. The E-Drags went into the core. Stone Slammer gutting it, flying through here. And he had enough E-Drags to finish it off at the very back of the base. What a beautiful attack when everything mattered. It was all on the line here.